Bandit, you scared me the other day, bro. I thought you were dead, dude. I thought you were dead, bro. He is old and is really hot. And found this dude like lying sideways, like completely, like, dude, I thought you were dead. Seriously, bro. I thought you like had to take a dirt nap, man. I seriously did, dude. He was laying completely on his side. We had to get him off. I was worried about his like his legs breaking, you know. So grabbed him, pulled him up, and let me see your eyes, boo. Come on, let me see your eyes. I know you don't like being touched. I know. So his eyes were wet. His mouth and everything was wet. So, like, you know, he clearly wasn't completely dead. But I was worried about this, dude. Where's the spot? Where's the one? There's the one. There's the hips. Right here, and if you get to right about, oh, there's the spot is coming up. Here's the front ones, you get a right about here. That's the spot. Huh. That's the spot, buddy. And so anyways, he was laying completely on his side. I thought he was dead. And we got him like sternal, which is like you know, kind of how he is now, but just on his legs. And then all of a sudden, this dude just shot right up. Like, hey, what's up? How's everybody doing? And just walked away all lummily. So now, took some blood work and everything. And feeding him a little bit different stuff. It's horse food, pellets, and high in nutrition and everything. And he just shot up, like out of nowhere. So now we're like just monitoring his food, and he gets hay. Well, he gets the regular food in this one, and then the hay here, which is alfalfa. And alfalfa is like Sour Patch Kids to these guys. They love the alfalfa. So it's kind of taking it easy with this dude. He's kind of cooped up. Your water's good. You're drinking, obviously, because you're peeing. Keep track of his poop. He's a pooping, but he's an old llama. He's an old boy. And so he's doing good. I was worried about you. And at one point, I looked down at him, and I was like, his head was on the ground. I was holding his head on the side, and I was like, if you have to go, man, you know, you can do it. You're all right. And first time in my life, I had, you know, I was thinking maybe I might see the last breath of a llama. But I didn't, you know. This dude's cool. It's okay, bro. Oh, I'm stepping in your poop. I'm stepping in your poop. There's the spot. There it is. That's the llama spot, huh? That's the same one for humans. The one where you go, oh, that's the spot. Rub that one a little bit more. Rub that spot a little bit more. Give me a chiropractic adjustment. That's the one, huh? That's the one, Crash Bandit Cooch. Huh. I'm Bandit Booty. That's the one. All right, let's go get you the wet. And should be good. Greased up your track a little bit here. The door closes now. We gotta do something about this chain. This is weak sauce. I mean, you're an old dude, but you know, you're not gonna, I don't think you're gonna come Hulk smashing out of there. Gotta always watch out for snakes. Never know when you'd be surprised, you know. Rattlesnake come flying out of there. Good morning. Gotta do a llama count. See which llamas are are here, and the goat meals. You want the wet partner? I know you like it wet. There you go. Llamas came from Afghanistan. So they have traveled a long, oh yeah, come get the wet, dude. Come get the wet. I know you like it. You don't like it on your head, I know. Well, I know. That one there, let me get your booty, dude. I know you like it on the booty. I know you like the wet on the booty. Underneath, you get it on your, your hoo-has. On the boys. Come on. Turn around, dude. I'll get you on the boys. I know that's where you like it. Come here. Everybody likes the wet. If you turn around, I'll get you more. Come on. There's your tail. Get it on your tail. Gotta get some of this stuff out of here. Come on, partner. Get you some nice little freshy fresh of water. Freshy freshy refresh. I thought you were drinking on the job, dude. I thought maybe you just had too much tequilas. One tequila, two tequila, three tequila floor. Not a me. Fill some stuff up. Something besides tequila for the goats. That joke, huh? Some waters. Because it's hot AF in CA. Clean off your dinner table. That's everybody's dinner table. Ooh, jeez, what am I doing? Spraying grease everywhere. I didn't spray the grease. That was for the door up top. Get this out of the way with my brand new today Skechers that I got from Ross, because I got the sugar. I got the diabetes, and so my feet were getting really torn up, and I gotta watch that these days so I can work on cars again, because this channel is Project Car TV, and but I had a heart attack a couple years ago, and I had a quadruple bypass. Took out I had what was called a widowmaker heart attack, and one of the coronary arteries that goes right in front of your heart and goes down right in front was 100% occluded. I had another one that was, so I had quadruple bypass is what I had. So I had four coronary arteries bypass, which had blockage, because, not just because I like pizza. I mean, yeah, who doesn't like pizza? But, I'm 44 years old. At the time when it happened, it was 420, 2018. Felt bad at my sister's house. She said, you look like shit. I said, I feel like shit. She said, no, really, you look like shit. I said, I feel like shit. I said, I'm gonna go home. So I jumped in my 2.7 liter V6 twin turbo Audi Allroad. Drove the 5 towards Los Angeles. Freaking had a heart attack when I got on the 5. Was driving, and 70 turned to 60, 50, 40, 30, 10 miles an hour. I'm putting my hand out the window, go around me, and put my flashers on. People were like, I was clutched to the steering wheel, trying to drive, and I'm like, man, I feel like crap. If I can just make it to the supermarket, get some Rolaids, I don't know, some Tylenol, aspirin, something. I don't know. Something's going on. Didn't think it was a heart attack. Went to supermarkets called Albertsons, Vaughn's. Anybody who lives around this way, West Coast. Bought a ramen noodle, a good ramen noodle, some chicken, a Budweiser, a Rockstar, a pack of cigarettes, and drove home, turned on some Netflix. Anybody want the wet? I got the wet right here. Llamas, goats, goat meals. Anybody want the wet? So 4:20 was a Friday. I slept all night Friday. This was around 11 o'clock at night. Slept all day on Friday night. Slept all through Saturday. Woke up. I would say I came to on Sunday. Just laying in bed, completely shivering, soaked with sweat. Reached down, my cell phone was somewhere, keys were somewhere. Grab my keys, grab my cell phone. I remember staggering out of my bedroom. Got to my 2.7 liter V6 twin turbo Audi all road with KO4 turbos. Had a plan for two GT30 turbos, 3-inch exhaust from the turbos back. Got to the hospital. I staggered in, and they pretty much said, "You, what's your problem?" They kind of knew, you know. Said I'm having chest pain, can't breathe, shortness of breath. They put me on a 12-lead EKG monitor. The doctor came in, who was a resident. He was looking at my EKG. Because you're having a heart attack right now. So you're going to surgery immediately. All of a sudden, the ER room was just filled with people trying to coordinate things, and gave me Valium to calm me down, and gave me some of this and some of that. Shot in a huge IV. Woke up from surgery. They had taken my radial artery from my left arm. Took my saphenous vein from my hoo-ha area, my groin, all the way down. Took my saphenous vein, and then they took one from my chest, which goes from like pec to nipple. And they repaired. Not fixed, because, 44 years old, and history of cardiac issues in the fam bam. And so they repaired as good as they could my heart. Had two cardiac caths since. Plans for a bunch of things. Ended up homeless for a while. Probably about a year and a half, 2 years. Ended up homeless, and it was horrible. I mean, it was wretched. I was downtown, surrounded by people just doing heroin and meth. I had a huge scar all the way down here. Chest tubes had just come out. I gotta turn the water off. Chest tubes had just come out. Recuperating in my all road. Didn't have any money. Homeless as crap. Lost the Audi. Because I didn't have proper registration. It was like 6 months overdue. And I had some bikes on the top of the car that I had built. One for my nephew, one for my niece, one for me. Out of parts that I had found. Nothing stolen, just digging in the trash. 20-inch rim here, 20-inch rim there. Bike frame here, handlebars there. Walmart hand grips here. Chain from a bike store there, totally legit. And I was parked. Yes, this is an E30. It's an E30 BMW rear-wheel drive. Inline six, 2.5 liter. plans are for a GT42 turbo, maybe. Throw one of those on there, make over 1,000 horsepower, rear wheel drive, E30 BMW. Has plans for that. Tahoe's got to get some work. Needs upper intake manifold, gaskets on the lower manifolds. Yukon needs some work. Yukon's got a it's got a 5 liter, I think. It's not the 6 liter. I have a Trailblazer, and I have plans to put the LS2, the 6 liter from the Trailblazer SS. I have one of those, so that's ready to go at some point. Got to do some work on that. E30 is gonna get a GT40, maybe GT42 turbo, something like that. And also, the other plan is for everything to leave California and go to Texas, North Texas, Dallas area, Dallas, Fort Worth. And so everything's got to go. Horse ranch is going to go. 10 horses have to go. Run of about 20 some odd dogs have to go. That trailer's got to go. That trailer's got to go. Racehorse SIP has to go. Everything's got to go. Dallas, Fort Worth, be rebuilt. And that is going to be logistically, wow. How's it going to happen? So those are things. Beat up truck, it's got to be rebuilt too.